Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fuera esta noche la última.
Staff Sergeants Jillian Mazzara and Anthony Pochetti from the U.S. Army Field Band providing entertainment at this year's Hispanic Heritage Month observance. Hello and welcome to Meade Week. I'm Brian Spann. More from Club Meade in a moment. Also this week, the PACT Act deadline is approaching and a look back at this year's 9/11 observance. These stories and more, but first a brief reminder about the upcoming Community Information Expo. The Expo features more than 35 participating agencies, directorates, and community partners. It's a tremendous opportunity to learn about programs and services offered on the installation and surrounding communities. For more information, you can go to me.armymwr.com or call 301-677-6819. Meanwhile, Fort Meade's 9/11 observance this year started 24 hours earlier on September 10th. The Fort Meade Garrison Headquarters Command Battalion organized a 24-hour walk, run, and ruck that kept the U.S. flag moving the entire time. Starting at McLaughlin Parade Field, the first two participants were Headquarters Command Battalion Commander Lieutenant Colonel Chaviso Cook and Command Sergeant Major Brian Sanders. Lieutenant Colonel Cook opened the event with a few personal words.
There's a bunch of numbers we can think about as well. 2,977 people lost their lives that day. We can think about the four aircraft. We can think about 8:46, which is the time that him and I'll step off when that first plane hit the first tower. We can think about 9:03 when the second plane hit the tower. We can think of 9:37 when the third one hit the Pentagon. Or we can think about 10:03 when the plane went down in Somerset, Pennsylvania. But I'm going to ask you to think about one number today, repeatedly. One. I'm asking you to think about one nation, America. I'm asking you to think about one flag, the one we'll be carrying. And I want you to think about you, one, as an individual, as you do whatever you do today and tomorrow.
Morning.
To reflect upon that time, where you were, where we all were.
In a related story earlier this year, the Department of Veterans Affairs announced an expansion of health care benefits to post 9/11 veterans who served in a combat zone and never signed up for VA health care. You still have to sign up, and the deadline is September 30th.
Are you a veteran who is deployed to a combat zone and has never enrolled in VA for health care? Well, there's a special enrollment period right now that gives you a chance to enroll directly in VA health care. If you were deployed to a combat zone and left active duty between September 11, 2001 and October 1, 2013, you should apply today. But you have to act fast. The deadline to apply is September 30, 2023. Even if you don't need this care today, you might need it tomorrow. And once you're in, you have access for life. And VA healthcare isn't only the best option for veterans, it's often the most affordable, with co-pays as low as $0 for prescriptions, urgent care, and more. Take advantage of the healthcare benefits you've earned through your military service. The VA is here to support you, so don't hesitate to reach out and ask us for assistance. To apply online, go to the URL provided or in person at your nearest VA medical center. Or you can call us at 1-877-222-VETS. Don't wait. Apply for the world-class care you deserve today.
Each year, September 15th through October 15th is designated as Hispanic Heritage Month. The Fort Meade MEDAC hosted this year's observance at Club Meade this week. This year's guest speaker was Command Sergeant Major Rafael Colon Hernandez from Public Health Command East.
And today's remembrance and observation day, it's not about saying one race is better than another or anything like that. It's about taking a moment in time and reflecting on how we got here and how we are a complement to the conglomerate that makes our nation.
We close with a brief reminder from MWR. The Meade Rod and Gun Club and MWR are staging the Fall Youth Fishing Rodeo on Saturday, October 7th at Burba Lake. As always, the event is free of charge and open to ages 3 to 15. Registration begins at Burba Lake Cottage at 8 a.m. and the event ends at noon with the awards ceremony immediately following. And that's Meade Week for this week. I'm Brian Spann. For everyone at Meade TV and the Fort Meade Public Affairs Office, have a great weekend and a great Meade Week.